Did you guys know that Taco Cat spelt backwards is Taco Cat?
Hey everyone, it's Ames and welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to be letting you guys know what my top three most anticipated Disney Plus Day releases that are coming through. Without further ado, let's get into this. Okay, counting backwards from 3, 2, 1, my third most anticipated show that is going to be released from Disney is She-Hulk. I am over the moon that they are doing this storyline from the comics. Hulk, Bruce Banner's cousin, played by Tatiana Maslany. I don't know if you guys have ever seen any of her work, but she is a fantastic actress. And if you've ever seen her show, oh my gosh, I can't remember what it's called. It's gonna be really cool to see gamma ray technology, like what they're gonna do. It looks like Hulk is in Smart Hulk form, so I'm just so excited. I think it's just gonna be such a well-acted show and there's gonna be so many things in that. That's gonna be so good. And she's also Canadian, so obviously, whoop whoop, go Canada. Okay, two, second most anticipated show from Disney. One that is near and dear to my heart. X-Men 97. I almost fell over in my chair when I was scrolling through. I can't even believe this.
Previously on X-Men.
Have they listened to people's prayers? It was like, are they actually doing this? Continuing off from where they left off? Like, Saturday morning cartoons. I didn't grow up having cable, but for some reason on our satellite, we had that. Like, Rogue, Gambit storyline was my favorite. I loved Wolverine. I loved Jubilee. And I loved the Dark Phoenix episodes with Jean Grey. So, I mean, those were very, very close to my heart. Jean Grey and Rogue are probably my favorite characters from that little thing. This is gonna be so well done. I am beyond overjoyed for this. So I can't wait. And number one, I am so excited for this. He is my most favorite Star Wars character after the beloved R2-D2, Obi-Wan Kenobi. You guys, Ewan McGregor is back to reprise his role as Obi-Wan. Now, I haven't loved the new sequels of the Star Wars franchise, especially after episode 8. It really ruined everything for me with Star Wars. And I was like, now I know how the older generation feels about the prequels, episodes 1, 2, and 3. I think I was probably just young enough, but what I really felt, even though it was cheesy, they just had storyline. They had a Jedi Master and the Padawan connection. They had lightsaber battles. I just felt when George Lucas sold the franchise to Disney and they went off without this plan, like obviously the special effects were really amazing, but it really ruined the whole story of Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader for me. There was like no Jedi Padawan connection, but I loved Ewan McGregor as Obi-Wan Kenobi. I thought he was great. And I am really excited to see this part of the story of when he's on Tatooine and he's looking after Luke. And they have said that they're bringing it back, Hayden Christensen as Darth Vader. And I don't know, I think they're really gonna do a kick-ass job. As much as you might hate that end scene, like, I don't know, every time I watch Revenge of the Sith and he's like, you are my brother, Anakin! It just touches me because he was so upset and he was trying to fulfill everything from Qui-Gon. But maybe, I don't know, maybe Qui-Gon would have been a better teacher for Anakin, but it doesn't matter. But anyways, I'm so excited for this series. What they have done with The Mandalorian, I just feel like that really helped band-aid the whole issue with the new Star Wars franchise. And I am just so excited for this little side quill. I'm gonna love it. Everyone's gonna love it. And who doesn't love Ewan McGregor? He is just a jolly good lad. And I'm so excited. I cannot wait for this little nugget of a show to come out, and I know it's gonna be amazing. And you guys, they've already said that like Darth Vader and Obi-Wan are in it, and like how cool is it gonna be to see them lightsaber battle again? I don't care what you think, but that's gonna be amazing. All right, let's do an honorable mention, okay? Agatha, House of Harkness. Oh man, Katherine Hahn. I have been a fan of hers since her first character actor movies. She is a genius. I'm so happy that she's gained lead actress
roles in her career because she is so amazing. Hilarious also. So I'm super excited when watching WandaVision and bringing in Agatha Harkness. It's going to be a really, really cool spinoff. It's going to be really good to kind of get more into that side of things. And I think, I don't know who else is in the cast for that, but I just think it's going to be awesome. And like more women, anything witchy, like witch, anything is next to vampires. It's like witch, vampires, zombies. That's kind of like the flow in which I love things. So bring on some magic stuff, bring on some witches. Also making Hocus Pocus. All the women look amazing. Bette Midler, Sarah Jessica Parker. But, you know, do you really need to make Hocus Pocus 2? Like, I just watched that on Halloween and it was great, but it's like, we don't really need another Hocus Pocus, but it'll be great. We'll see what virgin lights the candle this time. We shall see what happens. I digress. So I'm so happy for Katherine Hahn and I'm so excited for the Agatha Harkness storyline to continue. It's gonna be swell. Thanks so much for watching my video. Let me know what your favorite, most anticipated shows are coming to Disney Plus. Let me know in the comments below. Let me know your thoughts and ideas. If you like my channel, hit the like. Give me a little like there. If you're feeling it, subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao.